Hey everyone, welcome to this beautiful December morning on the Danish coast. Today we're going to be fishing for sea-run brown trout, which are more commonly known as sea trout in Denmark. Just in case you're wondering, why we have both Canadian and Danish fishery videos on this channel is that I spent several months here in Denmark, where my wife Nina is from, and you probably have seen some of her videos in this channel as well. So I've been pretty fortunate enough to be experiencing both fisheries on the Pacific and in the Baltic seas over the years. The reason we're doing this video in the car is that it's actually really cold outside. It is December after all. It's -4 degrees and there's a blanket of white frost on the ground. The sun isn't even out yet. It's just slowly peeking out in the horizon right now. The good news is that it's actually not very windy, because normally this is a very windy country and wind is a big factor when it comes to the fishing. The forecast is that there's a slight easterly wind coming today and we're fishing on the west coast, which is our advantage because the wind will be coming from behind us and I'll be able to do the cast further. So sea-run brown trout has a life cycle that's similar to a Pacific salmon. They migrate into the ocean as adults and they will come back into the river to spawn when they're ready. The only difference is that their life cycle is not as regular as a Pacific salmon. They might spend an extra year in the ocean at times. They're repeat spawners. They'll spawn and go down the river and go into the ocean again and come back as bigger adults to spawn on the second time or third time. This is a somewhat challenging and unique fishery, because most of the time when you go out, you actually don't catch anything on the beach. Because unlike the river, I mean, the ocean is so big that the fish can be anywhere. But when you do catch one, the fish can be 1 pound or 5 pound or 10 pound. So that's the exciting part, the unknown. You don't really know how big the fish is and how healthy the fish is, how bright or how colored the fish might be. In December right now, as I say, it's really cold, the water's cold, and the fish tends to slow down a little bit. But that doesn't mean the fishing can be solo. This particular spot where I'm fishing today, I actually did quite well last year, around this time of year. So who knows, maybe I'll be able to get one today by visiting the same spot, and that's kind of the nice thing about the sea trout fishery, because you come back to the same place again and sometimes you get disappointed, sometimes you get rewarded again and again. It just depends on a bit of luck, I guess. So just a little background about fishing rod. This website has been around since 2001 and it's more of a hobby of mine at the beginning, and then it progresses into part of my work over the years, and which is very fortunate because I've been able to incorporate this into my lifestyle at the same time. So for those who have been following videos, thank you for your support. In 2010, I think you'll find more of these blog type video journals that follow our fishing trips in both Denmark and Canada. If you have any ideas of new fisheries that you'd like to see featured in the videos, be sure to send us a message or email. I will do our best to kind of try to bring that content to you in the future as well. In the meantime, I'm going to get my waders on and brave the cold and see if I can catch a sea trout. Thank you. Sun is finally out, and it's not so cold anymore. I mean, temperature is still around zero, but that sun, it really makes a huge difference. Just like to show you guys where I'm fishing today. Along the Danish coast, it's basically covered with rocks and pads of algae, and that's the type of habitat that sea trout love to hang around. The rods are actually really hard to navigate around at times, and pretty easy to slip over if you're not too careful. And these algae pads are where you want to fish, because sea trout tend to hide in it. So I've been fishing for about 2 hours now, and so far it hasn't been too exciting, except I did have one fish. Not a very big sea trout though. It was only about 30 centimeters. But that's better than nothing. So, first trip of the year. One fish so far. Hopefully there's more to come.